Hello, citizens of the world. We are anonymous.
All anonymous who are fed up and ready to stand up for justice are invited to join us in taking down the Rochester Police Department webpage with a massive DDoS attack. Together we will send the message that injustice of any kind is unacceptable. No government or corporation can ignore the will of the people any longer. Just recently in Rochester, New York, 20-year-old Israel aka Z, and Ina was executed by a firing squad of seven Rochester police officers just a few houses from his Locust Street home on Rochester's northwest side. Rochester Police Chief James Shepard claims that Ina fired at his officers first. Witnesses say that is absolutely not true and that the Rochester police is lying in order to cover up the incident. And Ina, who had a history of mental health issues, got into an argument with his mother, pushed her against a wall, then ran out of the house. Rochester Police Chief James Shepard claims that Ina made a call to 911 saying that he had just stabbed his mother and was going to shoot other people. The truth, however, is that Israel and Ina never stabbed his mother, he simply pushed her and she suffered some minor cuts and bruises. Less than 20 minutes later, seven Rochester police officers opened fire on Ina, killing him instantly. A curbside memorial with candles, teddy bears and a wooden cross with black and red New York Yankees baseball caps hanging from it, marks the spot where Izzy's body lay. In the center of the memorial, a birthday cake wrapped in plastic. Israel Izzy and Ina was executed on his birthday. The sidewalk was still stained a brownish red from his blood. Dozens of neighbors and friends walked up to the memorial, crying and hugging each other. This young man did not have to die like this, in a firing squad fashion of at least seven Rochester, New York police officers who all shot 20-year-old Israel Gambino at the same time. Rochester Police Sergeant Aaron Coletti, Sergeant Mike Nichols, Officer Antonio Gonzalez, Officer Brian Kelly, Officer Greg Carnes, Officer Anasus Sokol, and Officer Ellen Rodriguez, all opened fire on Israel Gambino, killing him instantly. As many as 11 bullets hit Izzy in his torso, more commonly referred to by police officers as center mass. It is that section of the body just above the waist and just below the neck. It is where police officers are trained to shoot, and not shoot to wound, shoot to kill. There were at least three bullets that hit the asphalt driveway of the house at 103 Locust Street, which is where Israel was executed. The bullets made dents on the pavement, and you can still see the white chalk circles that Rochester police technicians drew around the dents marking where each bullet hit. At least three homes on the street were also hit in the barrage of bullets, including 103 Locust Street. There was a bullet that hit the porch and broke off one of the sections of siding. Little splinters of wood lay scattered on the grass in front of the house, from where the bullet penetrated deep into the house underneath the siding. Another bullet hit the porch's ceiling, which had to be at least 15 feet off street level, which is where all seven Rochester police officers were shooting from. That bullet then ricocheted off the ceiling and went through the home's front window, where a family was inside with their young children. A van, which was parked in the driveway and was also riddled with bullets, was towed away by the RPD technicians for evidence. The houses next door were also riddled with bullets. In all, at least 15 shots that hit the houses, not counting the 11 that hit Israel or the ones that hit the van. How senseless it was that a young man with mental health issues who needed help was instead executed by at least 7 cops. How reckless these Rochester police officers were to fire these many shots at 7:30 in the morning, in the direction of several homes with innocent families and young children. This young man who did not deserve to die, being target practice for a gang of trigger-happy RPD cops. The Rochester, New York Police Department ordered the owner of a corner grocery store to close, then confiscated video surveillance of the store's camera, which captured the moments before Uzi was executed. Witnesses say that the police officers had several opportunities to move in on Israel Gambino without needing to shoot him. In fact, several people said that Israel Gambino kneeled down near the store's parking lot and had the rifle across his lap, while he slapped his forehead with both of his hands. Witnesses say that this should have been a perfect time for RPD officers to taser Uzi, or use another weapon the RPD made a huge deal about years ago, but almost never use, the beanbag gun. A beanbag round consists of a small fabric pillow which is filled with number 9 lead shot, and is fired from a normal 12-gauge shotgun. It is designed to deliver a blow that will cause minimum long-term trauma and no penetration, but will result in a muscle spasm or other reaction to briefly render a violent suspect immobile. One of Uzi's friends had described Uzi as a good kid, and as someone whom his kids, especially his 3-year-old son, adored. He asked, "You want to know something I saw that I can't get out of my mind?" Then he said, as Uzi's body lay there on that sidewalk for almost 8 hours, uncovered, an RPD cop came over to the body, slapped Uzi's face a few times, then said, "Yep, he's dead," and chuckled. Not only did the RPD execute a mentally ill man in firing squad fashion, but even after this young man's body lay on the sidewalk, full of bullet holes, RPD cops disrespect his corpse and make fun of his death. Carmen Boz, Israel's mother, said, "I need justice to be done for my child, because I feel what was done to my child was unjustifiable for me. They never tried to talk him down." In the summer of 2005, then Rochester, New York Police Chief Cedric Alexander announced the creation of the Rochester Police Department's Emotionally Disturbed Persons Response Team, EDPRT, a team specially trained to deal with despondent, suicidal, and emotionally unstable individuals. Ironically, just days after Alexander announced this special team, 13-year-old Lashetica Mason, who was suicidal, grabbed a knife and locked herself up in the bathroom of her mother's home on Rochester's east side. Little did her mom know that, when she would make a call to 911 call asking for help, the responding Rochester, New York police officer would end up almost killing her daughter. Rochester police officer Mark Simmons shot Lashetica 3 times, including once in her abdomen. As a result of her injuries, Lashetica's gallbladder, as well as several feet of her intestines, had to be removed during surgery. Interestingly, the Rochester Police Department's EDPRT, which was developed specifically for people just like Lashetica, was never deployed. Anonymous will not tolerate this blatant disrespect for humanity. It is time to put these trigger-happy pigs in their place. Together we will continue to DDoS the Rochester Police Department until police brutality accountability is in place and there is justice for Uzi. We are anonymous. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.